Now I would like to invite our beloved Director General, Dr. William Dar. As mentioned earlier, he is the man of the mission, and Degree Set is privileged to have him as TG for last 14 years. On a personal note, I am also very much thankful to him for that whenever I approached him for anything, he never said no. And as a result, we have organized several meetings. Last time we organized this meeting in ICLGG 2012, which was the largest meeting of the legume community. And of course, under his leadership, we also got the bid to organize the inter-drought conference, which is again the biggest conference of the drought area we will be organizing in 2015-16. And under his leadership, this exercise from doing great. So please join me in welcoming Dr.
Thank you, Rajiv, for a kind introduction, that kind of introduction. We need not do that again. Let me welcome all of you to Degree Set, your institute. Can we give all our partners from outside Degree Set a big, big hand? At the outset, let me thank the sponsors, because without them, this activity would not have been possible. And I understand that the CGR Generation Challenge Program is one of the big sponsors of this important initiative. And Jean-Marcel Rebou will be coming, I understand, tomorrow, but in his absence and in the presence of some of the leaders of the program, can we give GCP a big, big hand? Another important sponsor to this event is the Department of Biotechnology, Government of India. And all these years, they have been supportive of the kind of work that international centers do in India. And of course, we are particularly thankful to DBT for all these years, because they have been a part of the success story of Degree Set. If there is such a success story, we have here, of course, Professor P.K. Gupta and Professor Siddiq and others. A big, big hand for them. The success story of Degree Set is also part of the championing and the support we get from leaders from the Indian Council of Agricultural Research here in India. And all these years that have been here, we nurtured the relationship with which now we have this very outstanding partnership. And much more when Dr. Swapandatta became the DGG for crops of the Indian Council for Agricultural Research. Swapan has become a real partner, because he has this shared vision of helping the smallholder farmers of India and the rest of the world. Swapandatta. And you know, the success story of Degree Set also is partly because of a partnership we have with Beijing Genome Institute. Now Shenzhen, Beijing Institute, we have John Wang, who will highlight and I understand from him that Gates Foundation is happy with the relationship we have with you. And we believe that, yes, it's because that you share our vision to help the smallholder farmers and the very poor people in the dry tropics of the world. Thank you for that opportunity working with the biggest genome institute in the world, Jun Wang and company. I'm not an expert of genomics, but I'm here representing the hearts and the minds of the smallholder farmers of the world, and also the billion poor people wanting to benefit from the work coming from next generation genomics. So that will be the kind of intervention I'll try to highlight during this message that I am now giving before you. You know, Degree Set has been here for the last 41 years, and all this time, of course, in its various stages of its development, We tapped the power of science and technology. We brought to bear the new science tools that are there before us. And I'd like to mention that with the help of the Department of Biotechnology, we set up our Center of Excellence on Genomics. And from that time on, when Dave Washington started as the first director of that program, and much more when Rajiv Barsney took over as the director of the Center of Excellence, that program has gone, you know, step by step until we have a story to tell, a success story. Rajiv and team, give them a big hand. We also see here a good number of our sister institutes, CMIT, IDA, ILRI, IRI, and others, those who are in the crop improvement work. I believe that through the GCP and other initiatives in the system, we would like to believe that the synergy that has been elevated within the system has started to work, and we will continue to really enhance that collaboration between and among centers, because there's no way to do, to go, except to bring the force, bring the power of the 15 centers working together to help the billion poor people in this world. I also see a good number of the experts coming from the advanced research institutions and the universities of the North. And they have been very, very, you know, dedicated, very passionate, working with the CG system and seeing to it that the work that we do together really benefit these people in the developing countries of the world. So that social responsibility to help smallholder farmers and the very poor people in the world must be recognized as well. A special round of applause to our partners from the West and the University. I was mentioning about our work in genomics. So we always feel proud to say to the world that we are the only CG center that have led the genome sequencing of crops, like the mandate crops that we have. We are happy to always tell you, because that's part of building up, again, the critical importance and highlighting the relevance of working on crops that are very critical to the, you know, food security and livelihoods opportunities for the people in the developing countries. So work has been done, the genome sequencing on pigeon pea and chickpea. Again, this is not just the sole work of the CRISAT, but the world is leading the consortium of various research institutions in the sequencing of very nutritious crops important to the people in the developing countries. Of course, not only the developing countries of the world, but in all those countries, even the developed countries, now wanting to have a healthy diet. Okay. So Rajiv Barsney has been the key and the instrument with which this work, this kind of work of tapping the power of genomics. And so today we have a good number of genomic resources on all these crops, chickpea, pigeon pea. And we are in the process, again, of leading the genome sequencing of pearl millet under the leadership of Rajiv Barsney in tandem with various partners from the South and from the North. And I would like also to add that we are in the stage of working a consortium in terms of the genome sequencing of fingered me there. So, yes, next generation
genomics
will be very crucial for building that arsenal we need to have to feed the world. You know, by 2050, there will be 9 billion people. And with all the forces against increasing productivity, climate change, and all those, impacts like drought, water scarcity, loss of biodiversity, a looming perfect storm is against all the strides that we have made. But because there is the power of science and technology that we can tap, then we will be able to handle this looming perfect storm. And I believe that with you, the best experts in the world, bringing together your minds and bringing new ideas, newer ideas that we can seed today, because this is the whole objective of this conference, seeding a new seed of ideas and genomics and the next generation genomics to bear on the very issues confronting the world of today and of the future. Because it is through science and technology, it is working as one, working in partnership that can make it possible for us to tackle the problems of food insecurity, nutritional insecurity, poverty, and environmental integrity, So, again, we are very pleased that you have come to participate in this important, event, because we need to have a good roadmap with which we can enhance our work together and seeing to it that we bring all the relevant tools necessary, science tools necessary, and approaches to help us go to the next level, achievement bearing on the development issues of the world. So without much ado, again, you are most welcome to this important initiative on next generation genomics workshop. Thank you and good day.
Thank you very much, sir, for this wonderful inaugural address and the guidance which you have given. We will continue to follow for the betterment of the crops of ICRISAT, which are a staple food crop for millions of the poor living in Asia and sub-Saharan Africa. Thank you very much, sir, once again.